are currently a few meters away from the church, and if you look behind us, there are protesters sitting down, and members of the church have formed a man barricade preventing these protesters from going towards the church. If you look closely, you can also see security personnel, armed security personnel, preventing protesters from going forward.
The pattern and repetitiveness of these allegations is worrisome, one that calls for urgent and immediate action. We believe that leaders placed in positions of authority must be subject to a higher level of scrutiny and accountability. While desisting from taking advantage of their positions of influence and power over their members, which often cause unquantifiable and sometimes irredeemable damage to the victims. We are concerned also that when the church authority refuses to take action following an allegation of such magnitude as rape, which is a sin before God and a crime against the laws of the land, it sends a message that the church condones such acts and is shielding perpetrators of sexual violence. This must stop. The allegations of rape and sexual misconduct levied against Pastor Biodun Fatoyinbo must not be swept under the carpet without necessary actions of investigation and prosecution. The church should be a place where its members can find succor, comfort, and protection. Hence, actions that produce the opposite must be condemned.
This march, this struggle is symbolic. Symbolic because now we have decided that it's time to start speaking. It's time to speak up. It's time to hold people accountable, especially people in the church who are meant to help mend broken people, who are now the ones actually breaking people.
We're hoping that from this, number one, parents will learn to listen to their children when they speak. Give them the freedom to talk about certain things, things like sex abuse. And then we're also hoping that the church will rise, because this is one too many, too many accusations coming from left, right, and center over the years. And it's beginning to look like do not harm the body of Christ. And as somebody who has read the Bible over and over again, this is what Jesus Christ would do. He hated injustice. Jesus Christ didn't want anything to do with injustice. And we're hoping that at the end of the day, people will leave religion behind and speak truth to power, no matter who is involved.
And also, currently happening behind me are a group of people who have been allegedly hired by the church members to counter the ongoing protests. As you can see, some of them are holding placards showing support for their pastor.
We are fighting for the rights of our pastor. Why are you asking the question? What bring you here? You are shameless.
You are doing it willingly. No pay, no pay. They ask him to collect
cobble.
Who
is Pastor
Biodu to you?
I don't know him.
You don't know him. So waiting with the talk here. Waiting with
this. They just call me. They make an online offer. Make an ask. They will pay me money.
So who all of you are? Who is
all of you? All of us are street workers, so some of us are labor here.
Who writes
this to me? I'm the organizer, labor here.
Thank you.
They hide for that.
How much are you giving now?
Because they have not finished, they will pay us 5,000 or 6,000.
Volunteer to come and stand for this man, because even Jesus Christ died for our sin. You understand? So we are ready to die for him. Nobody will lay allegation on this innocent man.